resonate, I think, very strongly still to the notion of Canada as a peacekeeper, because Lester McPherson won the Nobel Peace Prize, because he invented peacekeeping. And when Harper stood in the House the other day and said, when that Canada doesn't stand on the sidelines when there are evil doings, that, you know, in the Democratic Republic of Congo, 5 million people have been killed in the last recent history. I mean, it's appalling, 5 million people. And Canada has been asked not once, but three times by the United Nations to send three people to assist the Pan-African forces that are trying to establish and protect people there and bring an end to conflict. They specifically wanted that of General Andrew Leslie. And we were in Afghanistan and said, no, we can't spare three people. So the other, we don't stand on the sidelines. We stay well out of conflicts where we've been asked to participate in missions that Canadians, I think, would feel very automatically, okay, that's where we want to be. We want to, you know, the slaughter of these people wants to stay. Same thing happened around the Central African Republic, where we stayed on the sidelines. We've stayed on the sidelines in a lot of quite horrific conflicts where we've been asked to help. And yet at the same time, Harper has changed the language we use. I never thought I'd hear a Canadian Prime Minister try to tell us that we were a warrior nation. I don't know if you've not heard him say that, but he says we are a warrior nation. Now, my dad and my uncle and a lot of my family members were in the Second World War. My best friend, I was just telling one of the lovely people, I didn't get your name before I was playing, that one of my best friends was Farley Mowat, and Farley's experience in the Sicily campaign, oh my God, he was on a hell on earth kind of existence in the Hasty Peace, the regiment that Farley served in the Second World War in Sicily. It was real good. I mean, the stories are extraordinary. A lot of soldiers, my family and friends and veterans, risked their lives, no question. They saw horrific brutality going on all around them. They never would have described themselves as warriors. They were soldiers doing their duty. But this new iconography that we have to be bellicose and taking us away from all of our traditions, and it's very, I don't know if it's effective, I hope it's not, but if it gets repeated often enough without people waiting and saying, no, wait a minute, and when I say Harper held the mirror up and said, this is who you really are, when you hear him describe why people come from foreign lands who want to live in Canada, I hear a lot of this. They're about things like they come here as seeking freedom, individual liberties, entrepreneurs who want to, you know. So it becomes, I listen to it and think, wait a minute, that describes why a lot of people would have gone to the United States. Canada had a different set of shared values. It's important to have freedom. It's hard to figure out sometimes. I kind of deconstruct what Harper's saying a lot here. Why did that sound off? What's a little bit wrong with that? One of the things that they'll say a lot in conservative sound bites is, we're standing up for Canadians to work hard, play by the rules. Okay, well, besides the fact that I remember that from the sound, from the screenplay of Bulwark starring Warren Beatty when he was in the beginning of the film watching really trite television ads for politicians. Other than that, the other thing that sounds awful about it is that there's an effort in that kind of framing to bring to mind for Canadians that there are other people out there who aren't working hard and aren't playing by the rules and are taking something away from the directed audience of that message. So it's an attempt to turn us against each other, regional divide, or Canadians, new Canadians against newer Canadians, rich against poor, it becomes a land of divides. And what we've always been historically is a country that has, I think always, but certainly since the late 1960s when we brought in universal health care, has been a country that valued taking care of each other and shared values and community over individualism. And those are hard things to talk about, particularly in politics, where we never get to talk about values. All we have to do is provide sugar-coated pablum that's all about what we're going to do to boost the economy. Mm-hmm. discourse in politics is wrong, is